Let me start by thanking FICCI for inviting me here. It is always a pleasure to interact with the members. And I must tell you, this is not a customary thank you that you give at every opening address. These interactions with FICCI have been very, very meaningful and fruitful. Some of the initiatives that you just saw on the screen at the opening were actually the joint work of FICCI, its members, and the Ministry of Finance. For example, when we met, I think that was 10th October when we had this meeting in Delhi, and it was Mr. Shenoy and Mr. Uday Shankar who pointed out a number of small little things which can help the industry grow. One, of course, was the GST rate, which used to be 28%, now it has been brought down to 18%. Another one was about curbing film piracy. A third one was about having news on FM radio. All these matters have been taken care of by the ministry, and I must thank FICCI for playing a pivotal role in these initiatives. Now, when I joined as secretary of this ministry about 10 months ago, in fact, I joined on 31st May 2018, a good number of my colleagues, they said that you are on a hot seat in an election year. Many others thought that it is a very glamorous role, you know, you are dealing with films and television and whatnot. But last 10 months, what I have learned is that this ministry is important, but not because this is an election year or there is a glamorous industry, but because this is a very fast-growing industry. An industry which is growing at the rate of various estimates, 13.9% beyond. It is also an industry which provides almost 2 million jobs. And I must mention that the chairman and CEO of Motion Picture Association, you very rightly mentioned, and I'm really glad that you are clued into all the aspects of Indian film. So it provides jobs, it creates revenues, it is fast growing, and it also creates a vision of new India all over the world. In fact, I was in a meeting where the Chinese state consular, the equivalent of Indian foreign minister, was there. There was a delegation that would talk. And he said, Indian films, particularly Hindi films, are having a big market in China, and he would like to see some collaboration between the Indian film industry and the Chinese film industry. That is the type of impression that media and entertainment industry creates about the country. Now, having said that, there is a fourth aspect which I keep emphasizing, particularly in the ministry, on my officers, that this entire industry is a private-led initiative. If you leave Doordarshan, the 24 channels which we have on Doordarshan, the rest 875 channels that we have in this country, they are all private channels. If you leave FM Gold and Vivid Bharati of AIR, the remaining all FM radios are private FM radios. And if you leave a few films which are made by NFDC, the National Film Development Corporation, which comes under the ministry, the rest 2,000 films are actually made by the private sector. And if you take the DTH platform, other than Prasar Bharati, which is actually a free platform, the rest all platforms are private. So this is an important industry which creates jobs, generates revenues, makes Indian crowds all over the world, and is a private-led initiative. Therefore, the role of the government, which we have been focusing in the last few months, is to be a facilitator. I won't use the word regulator, it is more of a facilitator. If we go into various sectors, of course, it's already 12 o'clock, I won't go into detail of print and radio and broadcast, but if we just take the sector of film and entertainment, there are a number of challenges. One challenge which we have focused is to have this as a champion service sector. What it means is improve the screen density. I'm glad that you mentioned about it. While China has been increasing the number of screens, in India, because of the new malls and various regulations, the screen density has actually been coming down. The other would be facilitate film shootings in India. Just like we have ease of doing business, we want to have ease of filming in India. A film facilitation office has already been set up, and by 1st April of this year, that is another 18 days time, we'll be having a system in place of online film facilitation where a single window clearance will be given to various applicants for shooting permission, whether it is for railways or historical monuments or from the state government. The third initiative would be to encourage co-production. You know, while we have been producing 2,000 films in India, I think the content could be greatly enhanced if we have co-production agreement for stories which are shot jointly in two or three countries. Apart from the scenic beauty, it will also develop better relations and more viewership of Indian films. There is also a small but very important role of the state government. You know, all along we have been focusing, I think historically because of the role of censor board, the focus has been on the ministry at Delhi. But the fact remains that theatre licensing or facilitating film production at the state level is a state service. Many of the states, we just had this policy of Odisha presented before us, Uttar Pradesh, Jharkhand, they have developed a system of incentives for filmmaking. We are actually working with these states to develop some index of ease in filming, and also the best practices of different states in terms of incentives which can be replicated by each other. In fact, Honorable Prime Minister, he was here in Mumbai on 19th January to inaugurate the National Museum of Indian Cinema. He had even suggested that we should have a global film summit, not a film festival. We do have a film festival at Goa. He had said you have a film summit which will be focusing on the commercial side, what we normally call as a film bazaar, where you have producers, creators from different countries working together and develop Indian industry so that it becomes just like a world leader competing with other countries. From films, if we go a step forward, I think the next big issue or big challenge or a big opportunity, whichever way we look at it, will be animation, gaming, virtual reality. We are in the process of setting up a center for excellence in this subject at Goregaon in Mumbai. But this is one aspect. I saw in the schedule that you do have a session on animation and gaming. This could be another big step and opportunity for the Indian industry. Now coming to the broadcast sector, we have been liberal and thankful to Mr. Ronnie Skruvala, who said unregulated, it is less regulated. And I have always preferred, personally, less regulation to more regulation, and self-regulation to regulation by the government. There is no reason to believe that the wise men sitting at Delhi would be more knowledgeable or more prudent compared to the industry people who are dealing with the subject on a day-to-day basis. So self-regulation and less regulation, both complement each other. If you want the industry to grow, we would rather like to have fewer regulations, but clearly spelled out. And the system would be focusing more on self-regulation instead of having a class monitor sitting outside and trying to discipline people. On the print side also, it has already been mentioned, the revision of rates, etc., has taken place. We do have better systems for clearances by the government. But the overall, if I could say in a few lines, it could be that for this important sector to grow, one is the focus on change in technology. Now the way we develop, particularly in India or in other Commonwealth countries, it was platform-based. You know, we have different regulations for print, for online, for films, for broadcast. But now with the technological change and the convergence that is taking place, there is a need to rethink. There is a need to meet this challenge, and also which is a great opportunity in terms of the content which is being viewed by the customer or the client in the other. So this technological change, which is taking place at a very rapid pace, we have, in consultation with FICCI, the suggestion had come from FICCI to have a national media policy. We are not going for a national media, would be a very big word, so we have thought of having a national broadcast policy. The draft is being prepared, and we are working with FICCI and other stakeholders so that India should have a national broadcast policy. And the second will be a policy or a strategy paper as to how the film industry, film and entertainment industry strategy paper for 2025. What should be the incentives to be given by the central or the state government? The type of regulatory changes which are required for improving the screen density. All these things will come in the strategy paper that is being prepared by us. A third dimension to all these aspects is the initiative that we have from the private sector. As I said in the beginning, this entire industry is private-led. It is here that the interaction that we have here over the next 2-3 days, I think it will be very helpful for the government to know the views of the private sector, of the stakeholders, and then take a considered view, particularly about regulations or about the type of policies that we wish to have for the sector in 2025 or 2030. With these words, I once again thank the organizers. It has been, my earlier interactions also have been quite beneficial with FICCI and other stakeholders. I don't know whether you have benefited or not, but at least we in the ministry have benefited out of these interactions. And I'm sure these interactions, particularly the report which Lina always prepares after these meetings, they do help us in taking policy decisions. So thank you very much.